All right, what's going on, guys? I want to show you somebody real quick.
That I can use the will. Basically, I definitely
come watching
bank because I have a corporation set up with a lot of credit. I just borrow money from that corporation and invest in shit like this. And that's the shit
Rich Wayne.
You want to do.
For those of you who don't know, that character there name is Rich Wayne. And this video is going to be on how I feel about Rich Wayne. If you are in Zetegrity, take a listen to this for a minute. Take 5 minutes out of your time and listen to this video. Because Rich Wayne believes in shelf corporations. Now, whether or not this dude is really doing all the stuff he's saying, because he comes off really ghetto. And I thought I was ghetto. This dude comes off ghetto, smoking weed, writing the videos. Go check him out, Rich Wayne. But I do believe in his concepts. Whether or not he's actively doing all this stuff he's saying, I have no proof. You know, he shows what could be considered receipts in the videos. So I'm gonna give him the benefit of the doubt. But if you're in the Zetegrity Black Table Program, first of all, if you don't know what that is, check the links below. But Rich Wayne concepts of the shelf corporations and how he buys them and builds up the corporate credit and leverage them. That's basically what Zetegrity is doing, guys. But we have one thing that Rich Wayne don't have. Or you could consider two things. I'm just putting them together. We have the stock trader and the stock investor. So people like Rich Wayne have been buying shelf corps for years, guys. Shelf corps have been going on for years. The only drawback with shelf corps is it's been that you might buy one and owe some taxes. Like, we're rectifying that. We know that we got to pay those taxes off. But then the corporation is 100% legit. You got your taxes done. But with the stock trader and the stock investor, we're 10xing what Rich Wayne is already doing. So if you watch Rich Wayne and he's talking about those shelf corps, and he's not even talking about the aspect of using the shelf corps or holding companies. I'm that guy. I'm telling you how you can take a shelf corp, make it a holding company, because a lot of shelf corps you purchase nowadays are going to be in Wyoming, Nevada, Delaware, places like where there's anonymity anyways. So you can easily turn a lot of these shelf corps into a holding company. And you don't need to market the name, so the name doesn't really matter, because you're gonna create a operating company. You're gonna pick your name on your operating company. Like, I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna do business with the general public under my operating company, not my holding companies. Day-to-day business between regular people will only be done under the operating company. But Rich Wayne, I do like his concepts. I mean, he'd be high and he's all over the place. One time he'll be in Kinko's, another time he'll be in the properties that he just purchased. I'm gonna get a dude the benefit of the doubt. He's younger than me. He's coming off raw because he's young. You know, had I been still his age, I probably would be the same way, truth be told. You know, so I'm gonna give him the benefit of the doubt and say that he's leveraging these shelf corps. And he doesn't have what we have, guys. He doesn't have the stock trader and the stock investor. So Rich Wayne is pulling this stuff off. And we have Zetegrity backing us up with the Black Table program. And his Zetegrity cryptocurrency program he got going on now. Guys, we got a home run in the making. But I will be getting back to doing more videos about holding companies, because I don't want this to just come off like it's strictly just about Zetegrity. We're going to start talking a little bit about cryptocurrency. I don't want this to be a cryptocurrency channel either, but we're going to talk a little bit about cryptocurrency since Zetegrity is involved. I'm talking about on Coinbase, the real exchanges, as well as maybe what Zetegrity is doing. So if you're new to the channel, my name is William Bootsy Blandon, and we talk a lot about corporate credit, no PG, holding companies. I now have a holding company course, links below for that, and it goes into concepts outside of just the holding company. So you might want to check that out. A low introductory rate. Check that out. You could get $10 now if you're interested in getting on Coinbase your first time. The easiest exchange in the world to start your crypto journey on, in my opinion, is Coinbase. But if you use my link, you will get $10 worth of Bitcoin. So you want to definitely use my link when you sign up. But going forward, we're going to be talking a lot about people like Rich Wayne, because I really want you guys to understand the shelf corp thing has been around for a while. There are naysayers that say it don't work. Only for that reason. Like, you could be getting yourself in some tax payments. If you're using the shelf corp without the intent of paying off possible debts that might be accumulated under that shelf corp, it's probably not the best tool. But Zetegrity solves that problem because they get us the corporate credit. We take the corporate credit, pay the taxes, and then we go forward. So it's not like we're actually coming out of our pockets. Would I use a shelf corp though? If you came to me and said, "Will, structure me a good holding company," I would not go to the shelf corp. Truth be told, I'm just going to be 100% transparent, because I can help you do a very, very super inexpensive, even without a law firm, and we can get it down a very, very inexpensive holding company to get you going. But obviously, it won't be a shelf corp, you know, for a number of reasons. The tax liability, meaning you might have to pay some taxes up front. Other reasons why you got to pay a few thousand sometimes for these shelf corps, just for the shelf corp itself, you know, not even for nobody to build corporate credit on it. So I probably would just structure your brand new corporation, and we go the old school way. You're looking at 6 to 8 months. And you could have up to 500K in spendable corporate credit. Very doable, guys. It just takes time, patience, and structure. And if you come in with good personal credit, there's a good chance we can leverage that to get you your business some credit faster. That won't be necessarily, it might be a soft pull on your personal. The key is, on my channel, I'm going to talk a lot about places you can go to get corporate credit where there's no PG, or we could do a soft pull. So I'm probably going to be bringing on some lines or trade lines, if you want to call them that, that we can get without really damaging our personal credit. Because I'm all about corporate business credit, no PG. I want everything in my business, including my place I live. Everything in the future I want under corporations and shelf corporations, if you want to call them that. So that's what we're going to be talking about on this channel. Please, again, check out my holding company course. And I'm going to go finish watching that Rich Wayne video, see what he's talking about, just to see if he's on my level. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Thanks for your time.